Meanwhile, the governor is at Acadia National Park this afternoon.
Of course, this visit comes just 4 days after that rogue wave from Hurricane Bill hit a group of people at Thunder Hole, killing a 7-year-old girl. News 8's Keith Baldi is at Acadia following the governor. He is on the phone joining us now with the latest. Hey there, Keith.
Well, good afternoon, Shannon and Norm. Today was an opportunity to review what happened this weekend out here at Acadia, but also talk about the future. The governor did take a helicopter tour of Thunder Hole, where about 20 people were swept off the rock Sunday by a wave, and a 7-year-old was killed. The superintendent of the park says they have now estimated that the wave was 30 feet high. They also say that there were about 10,000 people here at the park on Sunday on Ocean Drive alone, the largest concentration of people officials believe in park history. That, they say, made it very difficult to control. And although they were trying to convince people to stay back from the ocean, some people did not listen. The governor says he was interested in this because Mainers use this park. The state helps coordinate first responder resources here and also wanted to see if there were lessons to be learned that are applicable to Maine state parks. But both the governor and superintendent of the park were wondering if anything could have been done differently. Because they were warnings, people were advised to be careful, and officials say while this was tragic, people do have to take personal responsibility for their actions, and they hope this is a lesson for the future. Live on the phone from Acadia National Park, Keith Baldi, News 8.